It's a daily thing that the adults are in and out. Now, this little bird is a little beater. So I say it's a little bird, and its name says so too. It is a tiny in comparison to what we're seeing from our vultures. These little guys are really very small, but are probably some of our most beautiful winter birds that we have. In winter, we tend to see a lot of our colorful birds migrate away, and they go into, you know, other parts of the world for the summer and the insect activity. But we are lucky that these little beaters stay around. So they spend their time here over winter, and they fly around from low perches like this, hawking insects as they go. And so a little beater, in comparison to that massive, almost 4-foot vulture, will only reach about 15 centimeters tall, which is, I would say, is about an inch. I mean, 2 inches tall, 2-3 inches, somewhere around there. So they're not very big at all, very fast, very agile in comparison to the laboring flight pattern of a vulture until it catches the thermals. These guys are a big contrast to the vultures in that they can turn and they can move very quickly, and they have to be because they hunt on the wing, so they fly and catch insects, whereas vultures, on the other scale of things, being so large, they aren't able to do that, and they then scavenge off carcasses of things that are already dead. But these little guys make me so happy. I love watching them. They provide a bit of color to our day, and they are just interesting to watch. They're constantly moving. You can see it doesn't sit still for more than half a millisecond, but the head is bobbing, it's constantly looking for food, tail is moving, and it kind of bounces around on the branch, and then they've short little flights, grab food back, and you'll often find them grabbing insects like wasps and bees that are a little bit, you know, dangerous to eat, and they'll actually go to a branch like this, and they'll scrape on there, and they'll try and remove that dangerous section, so the stinger of this insect, and then they'll swallow it down and into the stomach, and off they go. So it really is quite amazing to watch these little guys go about their business, and the bee eater name comes because they do hunt bees quite regularly. So it's the thing is they won't only feed off bees, they'll feed off a myriad of flying insects. So you'll find they'll go after flying beetles, and even things like mosquitoes and mayflies and midges and those kind of things will also be targets.